Hey guys, Ray at 321 Airsoft, and we're going to do a video here about some of the gear that we use. We get a lot of requests. They see our game videos, which is on our channel. So if you guys want to see some in-game footage and helmet cam stuff from our GoPros, go ahead and check out the rest of our channel and subscribe. We've got a lot of great videos on there. We've also got a lot that shows some gear. But we're going to start doing a little more team equipment, things that we wear out in the field. And today I want to introduce you to my model, Tacticarlos. Tacticarlos is a little pale. He's kind of sick. And this is stupid and cheesy, and I'm just going to move right past it. Anyway, you're looking at my Ops Corps fast base jump military helmet. Now, this is not a ballistics rated helmet. This is merely a protective helmet. It is impact rated, which means it could protect your head from basically skull fractures and mild concussion or concussions or, you know, things like that. But I imagine if you hit your head hard enough, you'll still get a concussion. But this will prevent skull fractures. So it's great for training purposes, but it is not designed to stop a real bullet. Now, this is the real Ops Corps helmet, so that's what they're for. We use them in Airsoft because, we have nothing better to spend our money on. We're a bunch of geeks who love this stuff, and we go out and we buy it, and we dress up in it, and play pretend, and, you know, that is what it is. I'm just not trying to be anything else, so, you know, leave your comments out. It has the arc rails built into it, so that means you can accessorize this thing with a ton of stuff. I mean, you can put the kitchen sink on the side of there. So we have got mine rigged out right now. On this side is actually a power supply for the turbo fans I've got on here. And let me introduce you to the turbo fans. These are the Smith Optics OTW Tactical Turbo Fans. That's kind of a mouthful, but this is them right here. The OTW, Outside the Wire Turbofan Goggles. This is a military spec goggle. It meets the US Mil spec 43511D43511D. And it's also the civilian ANSI rating 87.1 plus. You know what I'm talking about, right? If I botched the numbers on here and all that crap, this is a ballistic lens. It's not just for fun. It is a ballistics lens. They do sell a thermal lens for this, but the difference is between this and the ESS is the lenses on here are double impact rated. So you're not just getting a thin layer for the inside for thermal protection. You're getting a layer inside of these for double the ballistic protection. So they come in a pretty cool box with all kinds of stuff, a really nice case. They got a nice little case that's Molly. It's black though. I don't know how the hell they give me black. Well, I guess it makes sense. I haven't checked yet, but I don't think they make the turbo fans in any other colors right now. I haven't seen them on their website. Whether I know that the non-fan version you can get in coyote brown and ranger green and all that stuff, but my guess is they give you a case that matches the frames. Now, I've painted my frames because we're going to an event coming up here. Irene 10. X sounds more fun, but Irene 10 is happening at MUTC, Muscatatuck, Indiana, at the military base. And we have to be on Delta. Delta is green, which means I took my brand new Ops Corps helmet that was coyote brown, and I painted it green. Yep, that's right. Brand new helmet. Painted it green. So I wanted my goggles to have a little more less of a signature in the field and in the woods, so I took some of the black edge off of them by spraying them. It's a kind of a dusting of black, green, and kind of a coyote brown. It's the Krylon camo. The other thing I've done for my goggles is I've taken the big straps off, and it's cool about these Smith goggles is that they've got a quick release for the power supply. So the power supply is not woven into the strap like the ESS goggles. It is actually a separate module that attaches to the goggle strap, and then you've got this connector that goes to your goggles. So I mounted my power supply on the arc rail, and you could disconnect it, and then I took off the normal straps, and I actually put on these shock cord retention straps that Smith sells for their boogie goggles. Their boogie goggles are for the base jump helmet for guys who like skydive, and you would wear those little skydiver goggles, and then you would just retain them with these straps, these little bungee straps. Now, I can just pop these off because they come with this man, that styrofoam is loud. I'm sorry. But it comes with these little connectors that go in the arc rails, and this is where your strap will connect. You can see that? That makes sense? Is this going to be high enough for this GoPro camera, or am I Am I doing it again? Am I shooting too high so my video is... Let me bring it down just a little bit. There we go. Hey, hopefully that's better. But anyway, you can see that the strap comes off like that. And then the same thing on this side. So to release my goggles, I just grab these tabs. And you go like this on both sides. And your goggles just come off just like that. And there's the fan built into the top. It has a high and low speed setting with a button on the side right here. So, Smith, outside the wire... turbofan goggles, and they're about $40 cheaper retail than the ESS goggles. So if you're looking for an alternative to ESS and prevent fogging, they do come with a set of smoke tinted lenses, and they're easy to change in and out. What else is on my helmet back here? I've got the E-lights. This is for identification, and then for airsoft, the red one's great for death rag representation at night. Instead of using a glow stick, you can use one of these. Now, these aren't mounted where I want them to be. They're going to be kind of like this when I'm done. But I'm waiting for my Velcro to show up. I've got OD Velcro coming on the internet. So the two of these will be mounted kind of, well, I got upside down. I was going to mount them kind of like that on the back of my helmet. And then the next thing that I'll be doing is adding the war bungee system. But instead of buying the war bungee system, I'm actually gonna make it. I ordered the shock cord, costs like $7 for 100 feet of it, and then I just bought the webbing and I'm gonna sew it, and then I got the connector for it in the back. So I'll be probably about $5 into it once I part out all the other stuff to my buddies. We spent probably about $30 in material, and we'll make several war bungees out of it, rather than buying one, which is like $25 to $30. So it's a simple thing. This is a an IR strobe. It is not a real one. This is the BB loader version. I've had it for a billion years. I bought it from like Airsoft GI when it was, you know, when Airsoft GI was 2003 or something like that. I bought this. I don't know why I wanted it, but this is actually a BB loader. You push this button on the side. It doesn't even work anymore. Isn't that great? I push the button, it's supposed to pop up, and then you push it up and down, but look, there it goes. Check that out. You load BBs with it. Old school. Anyway, obviously the Velcro for name tapes and identification flags and all that stuff. I've got the mount here, and it's just a Rhino mount. Not Rhino mount. Ugh, damn it. This is the arm for the MVGs, for the goggles, and I got this at the surplus store. This is actually a real one, but I paid maybe $10 for it at the surplus store. I have the GoPro mounts for this helmet. So the GoPro that you're looking at is looking at the GoPro that I'm recording this video with. So GoPro mount, it's got the bungee cords to retain it in case it falls off or gets knocked off. We'll be able to record more games. Like, you guys notice on our channel, and if you haven't, if you're watching this video and you haven't looked at our channel, we've got tons of game videos on there. So go on there and watch our POV from the games that we go to. Take the chin strap off, pull off the helmet, and we'll reveal. I got them stuck on my contacts. You'll reveal that I have a set of contact twos here, headsets. These are the replicas. Move those out of the way. And then the OpsCore helmet, you can move the foam pads around in different positions. It comes with some extra ones too. The cool part of this is the adjustment strap that's really nice design. It cinches in like a hard hat and will fit your head really nice and snug. There's plenty of room inside here. Your head doesn't touch a lot of the padding, so air gets through there and circulates. So these helmets aren't very hot when you're wearing them. They do make a replica version of it. I can't talk to the quality of the Emerson, but they do make the Emerson version of this helmet. It'll cost you about $70 off the internet. I believe Evike knows. See, now I'm talking about other stores, and I shouldn't. I should be promoting my own store. But hey, you need the stuff. I don't have it. Get it where you can get it. This is a large, extra large, and when we ordered these, you know, they retail for about $235. In some cases, if you have like a military discount, you can get them for a little bit cheaper. But expect to wait. There is a huge back order on these helmets. This version of the helmet, you're looking at a 16-week waiting period. So there you have it, guys. That's my OpsCore helmet. We're going to put it back on top to Carlos here. Give him his goggles back, because we don't want him to shoot his eye out. So, it's a lot. This may seem awkward doing this, but when you have your helmet on your head, putting these goggle straps on is really easy. So, there it is, my OpScore helmet. Hope that concludes this video about some of the gear we wear on Team Spear. And a good 75% of us on the team have this helmet or the Emerson version of it. So, thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to our channel. Watch the rest of our videos.